Hey guys, welcome back to Coach Hall Writes. In today's video, we're going to be talking about how to have a successful campus tour. So if you're a high school junior or senior who's going to be touring a college in the near future, you're going to want to know these tips to make it a much better experience. One of the best things that any prospective student can do is to take a virtual tour. So go on the school's website, look at the different clubs that they have, the different sororities, the different majors, look at all their information. That way you can see if it's a place that you truly want to go to. This is also a great option for students who can't go on a tour. Sometimes if you're looking at an out-of-state college, it's just not feasible to go to that school and take a tour. So you can at least see what the school is like through pictures. Most colleges, if they know that you're coming for a tour, will tell you exactly where to park. However, if you don't know the area really well, it can be really confusing because there's a lot of streets, there's a lot of buildings that look the same, and so it's a really good idea to get there early. That way, if you do get lost, you have time to ask for directions, and it also gives you time to just prepare mentally for the campus tour. Chances are you've heard the expression dress to impress. Now this is true in a lot of instances. For example, if you're going to an interview or maybe if you're meeting with a scholarship committee, you want to wear professional attire. However, a basic campus tour is a very informal thing, and so it's important to be comfortable. Wear comfortable shoes and comfortable clothes because you're going to be doing a lot of walking, and chances are a lot of that walking is going to be outside. Campus tours are a great time to ask questions because a lot of the tour guides are actually students themselves, so they can give you firsthand answers. Now, the tour itself will probably answer a lot of the basic questions that you might have, but it's always a good idea to have two or three questions ready to go because it shows that you're engaged and interested, and in some cases, it can show that you've done your research. If your campus tour occurs during the school year, chances are you're going to be given a voucher so that you can eat in the cafeteria. This is a really good experience because it shows you what the food is actually like. Some big colleges actually have more than one cafeteria, so you can find out what is served in each location. This next tip is also more applicable during the school year as opposed to the summer, but if given the opportunity, definitely sit in on a class. It shows you what the school buildings are like, it shows you what the professors are like, and you can see a class firsthand. So you can decide if this is where you want to go to school, and it also could give you a little bit of potential insight into the classes that you might take if you know what your major is. This next tip might be a little bit stressful if you're an introvert. However, it's a great idea to use this opportunity to talk to students. So let's say you go and you sit in on a class. There's going to be other people around. Ask them what they like about the university. Ask them if they have any advice. A lot of colleges also allow students to stay overnight and you get to sleep in a dorm. So you're going to meet lots of people that way. You get to see what life is really like. But one of the best things that you can do is talk to the students firsthand because they're going to tell you what they love and what they might not really like about the university. In addition to touring the campus, it's also really important to tour the town. So there are certain things you need to consider. First of all, are freshmen allowed to have cars on campus? If so, what is the parking situation like? Is it easy to drive through the town? Do you have public transportation? Is there a Walmart nearby or a Target? That way you can get supplies if you need them. What kind of restaurants are around? Are any of them in walking distance? These are things that matter because you're going to be living on campus for multiple years. So you want to make sure that the town you live in is just as enjoyable as the campus that you're going to. Thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this kind of content, please don't forget to give the video a thumbs up and make sure that you're subscribed with your notifications turned on. That way you don't miss any of my future content related to college or high school advice.